Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. So in the previous session I have started discussing about quantum numbers. So what do you mean by quantum numbers? A set of four numbers which describes the phenomenon of an electron. Okay, what we said, a set of four numbers which describes the characteristic of an electron in an atom. Well, there are four quantum numbers present. We discussed about first two, that is principal quantum number, and second one azimuthal quantum number. Okay, just we recall the concept of principal quantum number. What it is a one of the quantum number. It gives the energy level or energy shell to which electron belongs. So what we say, electrons are distributed in a different energy levels or energy shells around the nucleus. These energy levels or energy shells are given by principal quantum number. Okay, well, what is the significance? We said the significance is it signifies the size of the orbit as well as energy of the orbit to which electron belongs. Similarly, we consider the second quantum number also. What it is? Azimuthal quantum number. So what we said, all shells or energy levels are made up of sub levels, or I can say sub shells. Those sub shells indicated by azimuthal quantum number. Okay, and further we consider the significance also. What is the significance of azimuthal quantum number? It signifies the number of orbitals present in each sub shell. Okay, well, now I'm going to discuss about magnetic quantum number. Okay, well, is the third quantum number. As like principal and azimuthal, now the third one, magnetic quantum number. Well, this magnetic quantum number, the concept of magnetic quantum number was given by Landé. Okay, well, and how it is denoted means, this magnetic quantum number is denoted by a letter small m or m subscript l. Okay, since l we know is a symbol for azimuthal quantum number. So now here, for magnetic quantum number, I am writing a symbol. One of the symbol is m subscript small m. It means the symbol indicates that the magnetic quantum number and azimuthal quantum number, they are interrelated. Well, here, what about this magnetic quantum number? It describes the orientation of orbital. It describes the orientation of orbital with respective coordinate axis in a space. Well, we said all shells are given by principal quantum number. The shells made up of subshells, which is given by azimuthal quantum number, and even those subshells are made up of orbitals. Now, the orientation of orbitals. The orientation of orbitals. Well, whatever the orbitals present in all subshells, they are get oriented, okay, along the axis or in between the coordinate axis. This orientation of orbital with respective coordinate axis in space is given by magnetic quantum number. So we can say here, magnetic quantum number describes the orientation of orbitals. Okay, orientation of orbitals in space. Well, it explains the even Zeeman effect. Well, what is Zeeman effect? So Zeeman effect refers to is the phenomenon of, or I can say it's a process, or like a phenomenon of splitting of single spectral lines into number of closely spaced spectral lines in presence of a strong magnetic field. So what happens in presence of magnetic field? A single spectral line is splitted into number of, or I can say series of spectral lines. The splitting of, or I can say the phenomenon of splitting of spectral lines where in presence of magnetic field is called Zeeman effect. So here the magnetic quantum number even able to explain the a phenomenon called a Zeeman effect. Well, the total number of m values means if we specify the values for m, magnetic quantum number value, it depends on the values of l. that is azimuthal quantum number. For any given value of L, M value will be 2L plus 1, means the total number of M values, magnetic quantum number values, depends on the L value. And how they are related? So that ML will be equal to 2L plus 1. Here L indicates the azimuthal quantum number, okay. So by placing L values, we can get the total number of M values. What these M values indicates? M values indicates the orientation of orbitals, or simply I can say number of orbitals. Well, so for example, when L is equal to 0, we know L is equal to 0 means it is the S subshell. Okay, so for S subshell, if I want to get the number of M values, so general formula 2L plus 1. So at the place of L, we have to place the value. So L is equal to 0 means, so here 2 into L, at the place of L, we are placing 0. So 2 into 0 plus 1. So what is the answer? 1. Okay, so when L is equal to 0, what is the ML value? We are going to get 1 value for ML, that is corresponding to 1. So this 1 indicates the total number of M values. When L is equal to 1, so number of M values will be 2 into 1 plus 1. So 2 into 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3. So M has how many values? It has a 3 values. Okay. Further, when L is equal to 2, number of M values. So 2 into 2, 4, 4 plus 1, so 5. So when L is equal to 2, M has 5 values. As like L is equal to 3, M has 7 values. L is equal to 4, M has 9 values. Okay. So generally, for a given L value, total number of M values will be 2L plus 1. Okay. Say, M can take the values based on L value. Okay. And what is the range? So what is the range for M, or I can say ML, means its range is from minus L to plus L, including 0. So we can say M can take values based on L values from minus L to plus L, including 0. Well, here, if I consider when L is equal to 0, L is equal to 0 means, and M is going to get 0 itself. So we say it has only one value. So S subshell, L is equal to 0 means S subshell. For S subshell, what is M value? We have only one value. Corresponding value is M is equal to 0. Okay. Further, so when L is equal to 1, so L is equal to 1 means P subshell. So what about M? M has 3 values we got already. So when we place L values there, 2L plus 1. Okay. So if L is equal to 1 means 2 into 1 plus 1. So totally we got 3 values. Means that M has 3 orientations. Thus, M has 3 values. What are those values? When L is equal to 1, ML values ranges from minus L to plus L, including 0. So L is equal to 1 means minus 1, 0, plus 1. So totally 3 values. Minus 1, 0, and plus 1. Say L is equal to 1, M has 3 values. We say there will be 3 orientations. So one orientation correspond to one orbital. Remember, here we get 3 orientations. So one orientation correspond to one orbital. Means when L is equal to 1, M has 3 values. Okay, means there will be 3 orientations corresponding 3 orbitals present. So I can say here L is equal to 0, S subshell, only one value, one orientation, so one orbital. So I can say S subshell has only one orbital. L is equal to 1 means P subshell. P subshell has how many orientations? 3 orientations. 3 orientation means there will be 3 orbitals. So we can say P subshell has 3 orbitals, corresponding values minus 1, 0, and plus 1. Well, what we said? Well is equal to 1, which indicates P sub level, which has, when you consider the m values, m has three values, they indicate there will be three orientations, or I can say that m has three orbitals based on orientation in three dimensional space, px, py and pz respectively. Means if you have a three values for m, those three values indicate three orbitals. Those three orbitals are based on three type of orientations. What are those possible orientations considered here? Px, Py and Pz respectively. Okay. Well, say if I consider values of m, if m is equal to 0 in this case, so we got three values here, minus 1, 0 and plus 1. So this m is equal to 0 indicates Pz orbital. Okay, out of these three, minus 1, 0, plus 1, so we specified three orbitals, px, py and pz. So out of these three orbital, when you correlate with values, so m is equal to 0 indicates pz orbital, and m is equal to plus or minus 1 indicates it may be px or py orbital. If a px is plus 1, py will be minus 1 and vice versa. So z always correspond to 0. Remember, the z orbital always correspond to value 0. So m is equal to 0 indicates pz orbital. M is equal to plus or minus 1 indicates it is either px or py orbital. Okay, well, similarly, if you go for l is equal to 2, say l is equal to 2 means which subshell? D subshell, or you can say D sub level. And how many values? If L is equal to 2 means the M has 5 values. And what is the range I said? Minus L to plus L including 0. Well, which indicates 5 orbitals based on the orientation in 3 dimensional space. Well, say L is equal to 2 means it is D subshell, and values for M, minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2. So these are the possible 5 values for D subshell. Okay, 5 values indicates there will be 5 D orbitals present. These orbitals are dxy, dyz, dxz, dx square minus y square and dz square. Now here, when you correlate orbital with the corresponding values, again, what is the first? Dz square will be always equal to 0. As I said, z orbital correspond to value 0. So in these possible orbitals, dz square correspond to 0. Then dx square minus y square, it may be plus or minus 2. Dxy also plus or minus 2. Then dxz and dyz, these two orbitals, dxz and dyz orbital, the corresponding values, they may get plus or minus 1 values. So plus or minus 2, plus or minus 1, 0. So here dz square going to get a 0 value, m is equal to 0. Okay, dxy, m is equal to plus or minus 2, that is dxy, dx square minus y square, possible values plus or minus 2. Dyz, dxz, possible m value plus or minus 1. Okay. So if I consider F subshell, so for F subshell, L is equal to 3. So L is equal to 3 means possible M values, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3. So totally how many? There will be 7 values. These 7 values correspond to how many orbitals? There will be 7 orbitals. Well, so regarding S subshell, there is no any splitting. Okay, that is, there will be only one orbital present in a S subshell. So there is no case of splitting. Well, here, when you think of p orbitals, what about p orbitals? There will be threefold degenerate, or I can say trigenerate. As we said, p subshell has how many orbitals? There will be three orbitals. So we say there will be threefold degenerate, or I can say tri-degenerate. Further, if I consider d orbitals are 5-fold degenerate, or I can say penta degenerate. Since 5 subshell has 5 orbitals, Hence, it is considered as a five-fold degenerate or pentadegenerate. If you go for F subshell has how many orbitals? There will be 7 orbitals. Hence, what is the name? F orbitals are 7-fold degenerate, or I can say heptadegenerate. Then similarly, if I consider G subshell continuous, so G orbitals are 9-fold degenerate or non-degenerate. Okay, well, so here if I consider the total number of orbitals in any energy level or energy shell will be equal to n square. So remember, the total number of orbitals in any energy level, or I can say nth energy level, is given by n square. Now if I consider the first shell, so that is n is equal to 1, so n square, there will be only one orbital, corresponding orbital will be 1s. Similarly, if I consider 2, n is equal to 2, so 2 square, that is 4, so there will be 4 orbitals. So 4 orbitals, what are those? 1, 2s orbital, and 3, 2p orbitals. That is, in p subshell, there will be 3 orbitals, s subshell, only 1 orbital, so total 4 orbitals. Okay. Similarly, if I consider the third shell, so 3 square will be 9, so 9 orbitals, so corresponding 3s, 3p, 3d, okay, 1 3s, 3 3p, and 5 d orbitals. So totally 1 plus 3, 4, 4 plus 5, 9. So total 9 orbitals. So generally what we said, total number of orbitals in any energy level will be given by n square. Okay. Similarly, if you go for 4, n is equal to 4, 4 square, 16. There will be 16 orbitals corresponding 4s, 4p, 4d and 4f. So 4s, 1 orbital, 4p, 3 orbital, 4d, 5 orbitals, and 4f, 7 orbitals. So 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7. So total 16 orbitals. Okay. So well, if I consider what are the magnetic quantum number values for 3s, 4s and 5s orbital. So what I'm talking about here, say, what are the magnetic quantum number values? Magnetic quantum number values means they are asking m values for 3s, 4s and 5s electrons. So what is the solution? What is the answer? See here, 3s, 4s, 5s, s subshell. For s subshell, if I consider l value, l is equal to 0. So if l is equal to 0, then what about ml? ML will be equal to 0. If you go for one more question like that, so what is the M value of, directly we have asked here, what is the M value of pz, dz square and fz cube orbitals? Again, pz, dz square and fz, what I said you, if a z orbital always correspond to M is equal to 0. Well, it's regarding magnetic quantum number. Well, the next one will be the spin quantum number. So what the name says, spin. Spin means one can think of, there will be two kind of spins. Okay, one is clockwise, another one is anti-clockwise spin. So here, when you think of spin quantum number, the concept of spin quantum number was proposed by George Unbelk and Samuel Goldsmith. Okay, so these two scientists proposed the spin quantum number. So well, how this concept arises means, so electron spins around its own axis while revolving around the nucleus of an atom. So in an atom, what happens? As we said, yes, electrons are revolving around the nucleus. Well, along with, electrons also revolve about its own axis. So it can be compared with our solar system. Say, consider our Earth itself. As Earth revolves around the sun, yes, Earth also revolves about its own axis. Similarly, in an atom, electrons revolve around the nucleus as well as they spin about their own axis also. So this spin of an electron was given by spin quantum number. So is the only quantum number. It is not related to rest of the three quantum numbers. So it is independent with respect to other quantum numbers. Well, here, as we said, electrons spin around its own axis while revolving around the nucleus of an atom. So well, here we are going to have two possibilities. Okay, so it may spin in a clockwise direction or it may spin in a anti-clockwise direction. So if say as electron has not only mass and charge but also spin angular momentum, as we said already, the angular momentum, since electron revolve around the nucleus, hence is going to possess a angular momentum, that is mvr is equal to nh by 2 pi. So electron has not only has mass and charge, electron has mass charge, but is not only has mass and charge, but it also has a spin angular momentum. Okay, this spin angular momentum is a vector quantity, as it has a direction as well as magnitude. Hence we say the spin angular momentum is a vector quantity. Well, so here it has two orientations relative to the chosen axis. Well, so these orientations are distinguished as a spin quantum numbers. So those possible values assigned are ms is equal to plus half and ms is equal to minus half. So whatever the magnitude for spin quantum number, we are going to assign two values. One is plus half, which indicates the clockwise spin of an electron. The minus half, which indicates the anti-clockwise spin of an electron. Okay. All electrons in an atom are going to have two possible spins, either clockwise or anti-clockwise spin. Okay. So here, if I consider any two electrons, so two electrons that have different ms values, that is spin quantum number values. So different means one is having plus half, another one is having minus half. So those two electrons having different spin values are said to possess opposite spin. Okay, if the values are opposite, that is one is positive, another one is negative, then those electrons are named as a electrons are said to have opposite spins. On the other hand, if those two electrons have same values, then it is said to be like a spin. Okay, so an orbital cannot accommodate, if I consider any orbital in an atom, so an orbital cannot accommodate more than two electrons. So maximum number of electrons an orbital can accommodate will be two. So for clockwise spin, ms is equal to plus half, that is ms, or simply say yes, spin quantum number, it will be plus half and is abbreviated with the upward arrow mark. Okay, and if you consider anti-clockwise spin, for anti-clockwise spin, what is the value? That yes, or you can say ms will be minus half, it is indicated with a downward arrow mark. Okay, so either consider the values, plus half indicates electron having clockwise spin or else an upward arrow mark. Similarly, minus half indicates electron having anti-clockwise spin or else simply downward arrow mark. Due to spin of an electron, that is we have two possible spins, clockwise and anti-clockwise spin, the spin of an electron is going to produce, what is that? Angular momentum. Okay, the spin of an electron which produces the angular momentum, which is equal to mu s. Whatever the angular momentum produced, which will be equal to mu s, and is given by mu s is equal to square root of s into the bracket s plus 1 into h by 2 pi, or else I can say instead of s, what I can say, ms. So mu s is equal to square root of ms into the bracket ms plus 1 bracket complete into h by 2 pi. So what is s here? H indicates the spin of an electron. Okay, so it may be plus half or minus half. So s overall indicates the total spin. How we get the total spin? the total number of unpaired electrons into 1 by 2. Since there is only one unpaired electron, half 1 by 2 is the spin. There are two unpaired electrons, 2 into 1 by 2. Okay, total spin will be 1, 3, 3 by 2, 4, 2, okay, as like. Well, so what is the formula to be remembered means? So mu is spin quantum number or spin magnetic number, mu s is equal to square root of n into the bracket n plus 2, Bohr magneton is the unit. So here n, again that n indicates the number of unpaired electrons. So any of the formula can be remembered. Okay, well, the two electrons that have different ms values are said to possess what type of spin? We said opposite spin. As we said, orbital can accommodate a maximum of two electrons. Okay, well, here when I think of characteristic, that is spin quantum number of an electron, as we said, electron may have clockwise or anti-clockwise spin. Now here in an orbital, yes, there will be two electrons. Out of these two electrons, say both electrons must and should be are what type of spin? They are going to possess opposite spin, or I can say anti-parallel spin. What is the purpose of this is to account for the stability of the two electrons. When they have opposite spin, then only they are going to be more stable. Hence we say whatever the two electrons present in an orbital, they must and should possess a opposite spin, or I can say paired up spin, or else even it is called anti-parallel spin. Means if the one electron is having clockwise spin, the other must going to have opposite spin, that is anti-clockwise spin. Okay, well, so symbolically how we can represent means, say an upward arrow mark indicates electron having clockwise spin, downward arrow mark indicates electron with the anti-clockwise spin. So it is considered as a paired up spin, okay, or anti-parallel spin, these two diagrams. One more diagram, say here in this case, so both the electrons are indicated with the upward arrow mark, means both electrons having same spin, okay, parallel spin. In out of these, where which one is more stable? The electrons having paired up spin or anti-parallel spin. In this case, electrons will be most stable. So whenever, while assigning electrons in an orbital, what type of spins to be assigned? That is paired up spin or anti-parallel spin. Okay. Again, if you consider diagrammatically also, so the one electron having clockwise spin, okay, another one is having anti-clockwise. So when electron spins about its own axis, is going to generate the magnetic moment. So what we say, the magnetic moment in an atom is due to spin of an electron. As the electron spins about its axis, is going to generate a magnetic moment. Say electrons is going to have clockwise spin, as it is rotating in a clockwise direction, it is going to produce a magnetic moment. So north pole and south pole. Similarly, electrons revolving in a anti-clockwise direction, okay, anti-clockwise direction, then also it produces a magnetic moment. So if it is a clockwise spin, as we said, ms is equal to plus half, anti-clockwise spin, ms is equal to minus half. So if I consider paired electrons, when in an orbital electrons going to pair up with one another, those paired electrons cancels the magnetic moment and develops mutual magnetic attraction. So when electrons get paired up, magnetic moment of one electron will be cancelled by another electron, so that net magnetic moment becomes zero and they develop a mutual magnetic attraction. Those electrons are being attracted with one another. Okay, well, with this I am going to conclude about quantum numbers. Well, it is clear for you. Again, in the next session I am going to discuss some other important concept of a chemistry. Well, thank you.